So this is Anaya. This is my little girl. She was born. Hi. She was born 7 weeks ago now, and this is her second module with the avatar. My name's Nita Lakhani. I'm a doctor that works in Leicester, but in addition to that, I'm doing this master's with the University of Cambridge. I decided to advance my knowledge on genetics and genomic medicine. So I did some research and we found this master's and applied and got a place. So I did almost a whole year and then realised I was pregnant. And the MST is a 2-year course, so then sort of it created the dilemma of what we were going to do for the latter year. When we found out that I was pregnant, there were some decisions to be made about what we were going to do. And obviously, for your everyday job, you take mat leave, and that's how it works. But for the masters, I really had a strong passion to finish it in the time allocated. So I approached Gemma, who's our lead, and we had a bit of a discussion about what possibly could be done.
So we have been working with some avatars this week, some avatar robots, and we're using those robots to enable a couple of our female students who've just recently had babies. We're using these avatar robots to enable them to virtually attend our teaching sessions without having to come in person.
The way we sort of do it is that we get up as we normally do, and I get her set up, and I get the avatar set up on this end, and she goes through the module with me every day. And then whenever she needs some attention, I'm able to give it to her without disrupting the class by putting the avatar on silent from my end, but still being able to hear. But also, I'm able to sort of see to her needs for those moments. And then when she's sort of settled, I'm able to go back to the avatar. You know, thinking about it, how could you get that class experience by being at home with a newborn? But actually, I found that being at home with her is less distracting than it would have been being there without her. So I've actually found that I've concentrated more being here because it's given me the opportunity to be able to do the two things that I needed to do in the environment that I can do it in. Obviously, the alternative would have been to be there and her not be there, and that I think would have been very distracting.
I mean, having two robot avatars was, you know, nothing special really. Really, what I did was I concentrated on the audience and then sometimes flicked the robot avatars, made sure that they were still on and looked like they should be virtually engaged, but otherwise, yeah, it was just like a normal audience really.
It's absolutely fantastic that they can come up to the avatar in the break and we can just have a chat like we did when we were there. And I love that component of it. I love that that they still feel that we're present, and because I certainly feel like we're present. So it's really rewarding. It's one of the biggest reasons why I think having an avatar like this is much better than having a system where the lecture is recorded or you know, you're simply on Skype. We're actually there, present. There is a physical entity there that represents us. Who have been named. So and you know, in due course, I hope get costumes. So we'll see how that pans out. It's coincidental that this is the we're celebrating 100 years since the suffragettes for the equality of women in politics. But I believe that today we're celebrating, you know, the equality of women in academia, and it's given us. I feel really privileged to be part of that.